processing software is great for working with information in text form. And presentation software helps us showcase information for large audiences in an engaging storytelling format. But both of these types of software have the same weakness. If you want your information organized, you have to do it yourself. If you want a program that can be used to organize large amounts of information, you need spreadsheet software, which is like a giant, never-ending table with all kinds of built-in ways to format and manipulate information. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to navigate spreadsheet software interfaces, create professionally formatted spreadsheets, and use spreadsheet software to automatically organize data. Let's get into it. My friend B will be demonstrating the different features of spreadsheet software using Google Sheets, which is one particular spreadsheet app that you can access for free by logging into a Google account, most likely your own or a trusted adult's, with permission, of course. If you have different spreadsheet software you'd like to use, that's fine too, you can still follow along. Most spreadsheet programs have nearly identical functions, so you won't be missing a lot by using a different one. All right, B, we're ready.
Hey, it's B again, and I'm really excited to show you what spreadsheet software can do. After you open a blank spreadsheet, you'll see an interface similar to this. As with other productivity software, you have a menu bar and a toolbar, which contains every available tool. Don't forget to name your spreadsheet. In some software, this will require that you open the File menu and choose Save As. The rest of the interface, however, looks completely different from anything else we've seen, so let's go over it. The main workspace of the spreadsheet, the part that looks like a big table or grid, is a sheet. You can scroll left and right, or up and down, and the sheet just keeps going, seemingly forever. This makes it easy to get lost in a sheet, but there's an easy way to figure out where you are or how to move somewhere else. Each section of the grid is known as a cell, and each cell has a specific name. Based on the row and column the cell is in. Since the cell I've selected is in column U and row 39, this cell is named U39. We can see that name right here in the name box. If you want to jump to a specific cell, you can select the name box, type in the cell's name, and press enter. If we want to return to the cell in column A and row 1, what would we type in the name box? Column A and row 1 would be cell A1. You can also select multiple cells by dragging from one cell to another. The highlighted rectangle of cells is called a range. Even ranges have names. The upper left corner cell, then a colon, then the lower right corner cell. You can also use the name box to select a range of cells. If I type C3 colon M7 and press enter, it will highlight the range of cells with C3 and M7 as the corners. If you need to highlight an entire row or column, you can simply click on its label. You can even drag across the labels to select multiple rows or columns. Finally, if you just need to highlight the entire sheet, that's what this button in the upper left corner is for. If the seemingly infinite size of a single sheet isn't enough, you can actually have multiple sheets within a single spreadsheet file, each with different information on them. Add new sheets with this button. If you double-click on the tabs, you can even rename your sheets, so you can tell at a glance what's in each one. You can type anything into a cell that you could on a presentation or text document. You'll notice that a large portion of the toolbar looks familiar. A lot of these are the same text formatting options that we used with word processing software and presentation software. But there are a few new tools on the toolbar. Like this Fill Color option, which will fill a cell or range with the selected color, similar to highlighting. This tool changes a cell's wrapping, so if the information in the cell is too long, it can overflow on top of the next cell, like it is now. Wrap to a new line inside the same cell, or get clipped or cut off when it reaches the cell's border. Let's reset it to overflow for now. This tool rotates your cell's text diagonal or sideways, which is especially helpful when trying to make headings stand out. This tool merges a range of cells into a single large cell, which can come in handy in more cases than you might expect. You can even insert other types of input besides text, like checkboxes, which can be quickly checked and unchecked with a click. Or instead of typing data in, you can insert a drop-down box with specific options to choose from. Checkboxes and drop-downs can be useful depending on what you're using your spreadsheet for. Now that we know what we're looking at here, let's dive into how spreadsheets can actually be used. One of the major uses of spreadsheets is creating organized displays of data. To demonstrate this, let's record some data. Type the word name into cell A1. This will be our header for column A's data. So go ahead and apply some formatting to make it stand out. Now, pause the video and type the names of as many friends and family members as you can think of in column A, one in each cell. I've got way more friends than these, but if I try to list them all, it will take forever. Now that you've got some names typed in, let's organize them. Highlight your data, making sure not to highlight name, since that's just our header. Then select the Data menu and hover over Sort Range. There are two suggested options here. You can sort in alphabetical order from A to Z, or backward alphabetical order from Z to A. I'm going to choose A to Z. Now all the names in our list are in alphabetical order, and we didn't have to sort them ourselves. Let's name column B Age and format it the same way as the other heading. Now pause the video and type in the age of each person you named. Do you notice anything wrong here? Chandler's name is getting cut off. We have the text wrapping set to overflow, but that only works if the next cell is empty. The easiest way to fix Chandler's name is to grab the border between columns A and B and shift it over. There we go. Now we can read all the names and ages. Move the borders between your columns if any of your names are getting cut off. I think it would look better if this data was in order from youngest to oldest. Don't just highlight the age column, though. That would only move the ages around, and then they wouldn't be lined up with the right people anymore. Instead, highlight all of the data. This will tell the spreadsheet program that the data should all stay lined up when it gets sorted. Now we go to Data, then Sort Range. The two suggested options would sort by column A, but we want to sort by column B. So choose Advanced Range Sorting Options at the bottom. The first thing to notice is that there's a checkbox for if the data we highlighted has a header row. Since I highlighted my headers along with the data, I'll click that box. This way, the program knows not to move the top row when it sorts everything else. Next, we need to choose which column to base our sorting on. Because we marked that our top row was headers, each column has been named according to the headers to make it easier for us. Let's select age so we can sort the ages from youngest to oldest. Since we're sorting by numerical data, neither A to Z or Z to A seems to make much sense. The key is to read these as forward order and backward order. In numerical terms, counting forward would be starting low and going higher, 1, 2, 3, on and on. And backward would be getting lower, 100, 99, 98. So if we want these ages ordered from youngest to oldest, we should choose the forward option from A to Z. And just like that, my friends have been sorted from youngest to oldest. If you think automatic sorting is useful, wait until you see how spreadsheets can do math for you in the next lesson.
Did B just say we can use spreadsheet software to do math for us? I'm in! In the next lesson, we'll learn how to use spreadsheet software to perform calculations and analyze huge sets of data. Until then, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. See you next time! Hey, hey.